This is the YGTV News with Georgina White.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Wednesday, the 5th of December. I'm Georgina White. Government response on caretaker government spending. Retired Police Marine Section officers visit RGP Marine Section. Royal Gibraltar Regiment multi-terrain pattern uniforms. Government committed to good government principles. And finally, GFA in UEFA Draw. The government stated this morning that the opposition has not dealt with the relevant substantive points on caretaker government spending. They explained that the argument is not about rules, but about what is in the constitution and what is in the law after 2006, and not about what there was before. The problem for the opposition is that the 2006 constitution makes its action unconstitutional and therefore unlawful. This is what the Attorney General has said. Despite the wriggling, nothing the opposition has said has dealt with the relative substantive points. The government is now taking advice on the next legal steps to take in respect to these matters. Commissioner of Police Eddie Yomi yesterday hosted a group of retired Police Marine Section officers to the Royal Gibraltar Marine Section. There, the retired police officers were provided with an insight of the roles and responsibilities currently held by police officers in the 21st century, policing out at sea and the operational capabilities. The retired officers were also provided with a tour of the new interceptors recently acquired by the Royal Gibraltar Police. A regimental muster was held in the Bufadero Training Centre last week to give the regiment an opportunity to parade together in the new multi-terrain pattern uniforms. The multi-terrain pattern was introduced after tests proved that it had made soldiers less likely to be seen by the enemy, and it is designed to work in several climates because of its ability to ventilate for cooling or layer for warmth. The regimental master also gave commanding officer Lieutenant Colonel Colin Tiso MC the opportunity to present two medals. The first was to Corporal Michael Tierney, who has earned a Long Service and Good Conduct Medal, which is awarded to service personnel who have served 15 years reckonable service without disciplinary action. The commanding officer then went on to present Carla Sergeant James Hernandez with a Volunteer Reserve Service Medal with clasp, which is presented to territorial soldiers who complete 10 years service. The Chief Minister has told the Joint Ministerial Council of the Overseas Territories that Her Majesty's Government of Gibraltar is committed to the principles of good government and that this is reflected in the manifesto commitments and policies that have been implemented in Gibraltar. Mr. Bicardo was invited to lead the discussion on working together for better government in response to the contribution from the Attorney General of England and Wales, Dominic Grieve, QCMP. The session was chaired by the Minister for the Overseas Territories, Mark Simmons, MP. The Chief Minister outlined the many improvements that have been made in Gibraltar since the GSLP Liberals came into office. Mr. Bicardo explained how there was now more information in the public domain than ever before. And finally, after yesterday's draw by UEFA saw Gibraltar drawn against France, Montenegro and San Marino in the preliminary round of the UEFA futsal competition, the GFA were again involved in two other UEFA competitions this morning for the under-17s and under-19s competitions. For the futsal tournament, a record 44 sides entered, and Gibraltar joined other debutants, Wales, Denmark and Sweden, in the preliminary round of the competition. France will host Gibraltar's group, Group A, and should Gibraltar progress to the next phase, they will face Italy, Hungary and Finland in Group 1 after the main round draw also took place. That's YGTV News. We're back tomorrow evening. See you then.